Let me show you a social media managing tool that's going to save you a ton of time in your business. We're going to make this a review, and no, I'm not going to make you watch a 30-minute video to let you know how to use this tool and if you should get it or not. Now, on this tool, I'm going to show you that you can schedule, you can view, you can respond to messages, you can add your social media profiles, view them all at once, analytics, and create reports all in this video. So let's go check it out right now. So this is my dashboard for Vista Social. And like I said, I'm not going to make you watch a 30-minute video. So what it's going to do, it's going to help you schedule posts, view analytics, and everything's going to be super easy. The first thing you're going to do is add your profiles. So in Quick Add, go to Social Profiles, select your brand. And in this brand, these are the social media profiles that you can add as of now. So on terms of Facebook, it's fan pages and groups. Be aware that if you add your Facebook group, you'll need to add an app inside of your group. So in my case, this is my group. You need to go to the menu and go to group apps and add the Vista Social app, right? There's the Google Businesses, Instagram, Business Creator, and Personal. Now, there's some differences in this. If you're using Business or Creator, you get access to do this. If it's personal, you can do this. Now, if you're on Instagram, you have the option to switch to business account. So just a quick heads up. And you get all these other profiles. Now, some of these I haven't seen usually in other social media managers, which I think is pretty good, like Trustpilot, Bitly, Yelp, TripAdvisor, and OpenTable. These are not common ones that they add. So that's a big plus for Vista Social. And that's a negative for the other ones that don't have that, okay? TikTok is a popular one right now, and Twitter. So those are the ones that you're going to add. Once you connect to these, it's super easy. Click on it, allow access, and it's going to connect to these profiles, all right? Now, in this case, I've connected my Instagram, my fan page, my group, and my Reddit account, all from here. And once you connect these, the magic is going to start automatically, okay? So first of all, if we view our calendar, we're going to view what's going on with these profiles. So in this case, I am going to select my fan page, okay? And this is what's going on my fan page. If I hover over this, this is pretty neat. I'm able to view what's been going on in this week for that fan page. So in this case, I have some days where I'm not posting anything, which I think is maybe it's too much content, or maybe I do need to fill in those spots. So something I need to consider. Now, we have some settings here where I want to view small preview. I can view the thumbnail, large preview if I want to view this, and condense view, okay? I like this one because basically it shows me everything really quickly and I can just hover over these. I can refresh, I can view by calendar, I can view by all posts, drafts, failed posts, etc. And kind of just filter these. I can view my month, week, daily, view next month, nothing's going on there, past month. Now, something I like about this is that it reads from, I think, 2 to 3 months past, okay, from when you connected. Select your time zone, select filters, and that's for the calendar view, okay? Now, if I want to create a post, it's super easy, okay? I'll go to my dashboard. I'll do it from here, okay? In this one here, I have the new post, which is pretty much basically what all social media managers can do, okay? So what do? You write your message, you have emojis, hashtags, some information here, you have some AI. And in this case, remember, this is license tier one, and I'm pretty fine with 10 profiles with this. You can use this AI, but it's only like a test one, unless you're on license tier three, okay? So if you have that, you can use the AI, all right? Then we have select labels. So I've created these labels. If it's an affiliate, if it's AI, if it's news, if it's an update, I selected. So just really quickly, I'll upload an image right here. That's something I was testing out. And I'll just say test here. You can see I'm getting a preview for this. There we go. Some labels. I'll just say this is some news because I want to keep track of what's going on. And then we have the customizer post. By default, it's going to grab this information, but I can overwrite this with this right here. So write your own content if I want to, okay? Publish as an image, publish as a story. So depending on the social media profile that you're connected, you're going to have that option, okay? Auto publish, send reminder, notification, post comment. I think this is a really awesome feature. And what it does is that for the fan pages, okay? So that's Facebook fan page. When you make this post, it's going to automatically add this comment to it. Now, this is a really useful strategy because let's just say I post this with an image and there's a link about it. I don't want to post it in the description, but I do want to post it in the first comment. Well, I use this, okay? Here we go. If you want to use location, which is something I don't like, I don't want to use that, you can use it. Okay, you have that option. Now, you can save this as a draft if you're not going to publish it now. You can add it to queue. You can schedule this for a later date, and you can publish it right now, which I'm not going to do. Now, remember, we have the profiles connected here, and we can select which ones we want to post or not post to. Okay, so if I select all these, it's going to post there. Now, I'm not going to select Reddit because it's not able to do this with the image. Okay, now I'm not going to post. I am going to cancel. So that's how easy it is to make a post or schedule a post. Now, there's other features that Vista Social has. In Create, you have the ideas. You can write some ideas here to kind of remind yourself what you want to write about. So it's like a little a whiteboard. That's what I would say. So if I want to create an idea, I write about it, or I can use AI to help me generate these ideas, and I save them here for later if I want to do something with it. So this is just something I wrote here really quickly, and I can create a post about this idea if I like. They also have the generate ideas. So write the business account, the about, and the target audience, and you're going to get some ideas for that. Again, it's using AI. If you're on the license tier 1 or 2, you don't get access to that. It's just a limited test. Okay. Now, dashboard, let's go back. Aside from that, there's the bulk publishing. If you're going to do some bulk publishing, if you are doing for a business, this would be a great idea. The find content, this is a pretty cool feature. Again, something not common on other social media managers. And it's like finding content that's interesting that you can use. Now, I'll use, for example, this one, Instagram hashtags. And I'll just say right now, Barbie. It's like the movie that's going on right now. That's how you write it? No, that's how you say it. Barbie, right now, it's like the hot thing. And I want to search for it. And let's see what ideas I get. I can use something like this. And I can use it to create a post. And one of the cool things that I like about this is that it's going to add the credits to this person. So automatically, it's going to write, you know what, it's from this person. It's their image. They created it. I'm not trying to steal the whole thing. I'm just trying to repost this idea per se, okay? And you can modify all of this. And again, same options like scheduling a post or posting. You get it there. Again, I'm going to remove it. So it's a pretty cool idea to get these ideas from different sources, like find the latest news, Instagram hashtags, Instagram users, etc., and create posts from there. So it's like, if you don't have ideas, find some here, okay? There's no excuse. Then we have create. There's a smart publishing. So if I select smart publishing, this is a really cool feature also. Again, something not common in social media managers. What it does, it's going to find related posts in trending news, for example, or specific blog RSS. That's really cool. So if you know of a really good source for an RSS feed, grab information from there, and it's going to post when it finds certain keywords, okay? So for example, I'll use trending news. I'll use the country. I'll say United States is fine. Category for this, I'll say business. Publishing time, right away, or queue next, queue last, or save as a draft, just in case if you want to play it on the safe side and not just auto post. Maximum post per day. Maybe you don't want to go 5. I'll say 2. Select 2. And then filter keywords. So if it's going to say no filter, it's just going to find the news and do it. But if we do any of the keywords, I could say you want include open AI. That's one of the keywords I wanted to find and post about it. Must not include keywords, maybe something else that you want to filter out. Assign for review. If you want to assign this, it's possible. Customize your post. Oh, something I forgot to show you. Pre-pen text and add pen text. So from the information that it finds and it auto posts, you can add some data before it and after it, okay? Then you have your customized post here, okay? Auto publish, post comments, country targeting, etc., and create. So this is going to run automatically and make the post for you based on what you selected. So in my case, I selected for news for 2 of my profiles. So in this case, I've selected it for, let me go into settings. Go into settings, and this is for trending news, business, for OpenAI. If it's any of these keywords, in this case, I'm just interested in OpenAI. It's going to make the post. 1 a day. So I'm not going overboard on this, okay? Then there's the Instagram planner and the TikTok planner, which is obviously based for those. The options are specific for those. So it's pretty cool that you got that. That's for the posting. That's for getting your profiles connected. The calendar, your media, everything that you're going to upload, you're going to view it here. Your inbox. So in inbox, this is where you're going to view the messages. So I'm not sure if I have messages here. No, I don't. Not on this one. No, I have on that one, but I want to keep it I don't want to show that, all right? But you have your messages here and you can respond from here, okay? So it's pretty cool. You have your all messages and your unread. Then there's the listening. Listening is another great feature. Now, I know you're going to say to yourself, everything is great. Well, this is interesting things, okay? And you decide if you need this or not. Maybe it could be something like, you know what? I don't care about it. Listening, what it does. So for example, I created this simple profile right here. Well, listener would say, and what it's listening for is, I named this good. That's just the title so I can find it. And any of these keywords, if it finds love, perfect, or nice, it's going to listen for it and let me know. Well, basically, I need to select the profiles. Forgot to do that. Save. So in these profiles, it's going to listen for that. And the other one is alerts. So if alerts, I find some keywords that says fraud, block, fake, hate, stupid, something like that, it's going to alert me, okay? So it's listening for that. Again, I'll select the profiles that I want to use for. Next is reviews. For reviews, obviously, it's obvious for like Google Business or pages that have reviews. You'll view them here, okay? There's the task if you want to use this feature. So if you want to open task, my open task, etc., you'll have them here. That's when you start scheduling posts and assigning people and all of that, or your team members, you'll find them there. Next is reports. So for reports, I'll show you this page. Not much is going on, but I don't want to show my other things. So I'll run a report and you have these options. So remember, I'm on license tier 1, not on 3. I can't customize the branding on this. But if it's just for me, just trying to find out what I need, it's fine. Or if your client doesn't mind, you're fine with this. Social media performance, post performance, review performance, task performance. I'll use social media performance. Like I said, not much going on. Followers, posts, engagements. This is just a fan page that I don't use much. So you're going to get a report like this. You can filter this out and you can download it. Pretty cool to have it. Something really easy to use. That's for that. And for quick add, basically what we did over there, which was post, profiles, social media profiles, add profile groups, and add team members, all from there. Vista Social, that is the social media managing platform. Now, the big question is, should you get this or not? Basically, if you need a social media managing platform, you don't have another one, and you're paying month to month, definitely get this. I mean, there's not much to think about. But if you have other social media managing tools that can do what you basically need, if you are already scheduling over there, if you are fine with posting over there and everything is working fine, then you're good to go. I mean, you don't need this. But if you want the extra benefits of the extra tools like the listener, like the ideas feature, like the smart, the fine content and all of this, definitely get this, okay? Now remember, there's a lifetime deal going on right now that's going to be gone soon. There's a 60-day money-back guarantee that if you don't like this when you test it, again, you can go ahead and return it and get your money back. So definitely, it's a must try if you need to schedule a post and get reports for your social media accounts. So definitely check it out. And that's a wrap for Vista Social.